Welcome back to Ruby on Nails, and today I have some berries and cream. Berries and cream. I'm a little man who likes berries and cream. Nail art for you. Once again, today's video is sponsored by Syrup Nails, which is a vegan, cruelty-free, and tin-free brand. They are also made in the US, so if you are located in the United States, you are also buying locally. I thought today it would be really, really fun to do some TikTok-inspired nail art because the Berries and Cream song has been stuck in my head for weeks now. Of course, here is your sneaky peeky of the nail art, but it's again in black and white because you have to wait till the end of the video to fully enjoy it. Of course, this isn't a literal interpretation of the song, it is mostly just inspired. And for today's nail art, I am going to be using Syrup Nails, all of their polishes, and a few bonus polishes just because they don't have a stamping polish currently. But with that, let's jump into this tutorial because I can't keep singing the Berries and Cream song in my head. Let's jump into it. Me oh my, that was quite the transition. To kick things off, I'm gonna be using my Peely base coat from Hollow Taco because I paint my nails several times a day and I don't wanna hassle with the acetone. However, I have been using a lot of acetone because I have some projects coming up that you can't see yet, so I am going to be using Hollow Taco Smoothing Base Coat just to hide some of those unnatural blemishes. Once our canvas is good and dry and smooth, we get to move on to the first part of our gradient, which is applying our lightest color as our base to ensure that our gradient is as smooth as possible. That is, of course, going to be two layers of Mimosa by Syrup. For this specific gradient, this could easily have been Mimosa or it could have been Bubbly. That is up for your discretion if you have these specific polishes, but if you're just making this gradient at home, I would honestly say starting off with the orange shade is probably for the best. Once my polish layers are good and dry, which is about 5 to 10 minutes, we get to move on to the next step, which is sponging on that gradient. I like to use some protective peel around my nail when I'm applying a gradient. However, if you are brave, you can just go ahead and do it on your bare skin. However, you can also use other barrier methods like band-aids or tape. If you do use a liquid latex, it will add a few more minutes to that drying time overall, which is always a good thing. For our gradient, I am going to be using I'm Here, Botanical Gardens, Mimosa, and Bubbly for our gradient, and I'm just going to be applying it in the order that you see here. However, if you're doing this at home, you can do it in any order that you want. I just thought going from lightest to darkest would look extremely good for this Berries and Cream themed nail art. So we get some of that nice berry tone with a little bit of milkiness added into it. For these particular polishes and for these particular colors, I did need to sponge on three layers to get a good opaque gradient. If you're using other polishes or other effects, that will depend on the formulas you are particularly using. However, for these ones, because that Botanical Gardens and Bubbly is a little bit more on the sheer side, I needed those three coats in order to get good opacity of each color and a good blend, because, you know, nothing is worse than a chunky blend in a gradient, unless that's the vibe you're going for, and if so, all the luck to you. Because this isn't a literal interpretation of the Berries and Cream sound bite, I am really enthralled with this color scheme that I have going on. I think it represents the berry part just lovely, and then the stamp that I am using will highlight that because it's a wonderful mixture of strawberries, raspberries, blackberries, and some good old strawberry leaves, which I don't know about you, but I really like how strawberry leaves look. I just think they are such detailed little clusters of wonderfulness. But maybe I just like plants too much, which is fair. I have over 50 in my house. For our stamping color, I am going to be using turquoise from Maniology, and I just like that this is a good contrasting color with those bright, vivid pinks and orange. I always like a good teal and pink combo. I just think it's nice. If you are looking for a more detailed stamping tutorial, I will put it in the cards above because I have a video that I can reference now for that. Oh my god, it's like I'm a real channel now.
And while things look a little drab and dreary right here, let's add that last layer of top coat to really make sure that our gradient is smooth, our stamping is popping, like just everything is fixed with a final layer of top coat. Unless it's a matte top coat you're doing, then you gotta wait like 30 seconds. Now that we are no longer diamonds in the rough, we can admire this beautiful look. And that's the end of the tutorial. And I just have a few more words, so let's go back to my face because the voiceover is boring now.
And with that final layer of super glossy top coat, we have come to the end of our tutorial. If you like this video, like this video, and if you like my videos, make sure to subscribe down below. All of my social medias are also linked for you in the description down below. Leave a comment telling me what your favorite TikTok sound is right now. I definitely have a few favorites that are stuck in my head and not fully appropriate for this video because we are sponsored and we gotta respect our sponsors. And with that, thank you so much for watching. I'll see you guys next time. Bye.
By the way, let's just admire this sweater. Like,
it's so satisfying.